Hello, everybody, and welcome to my exercise 9-1. So determine the inventory as of December 31st by the lower of cost or net realizable value method, applying this to each item. So what we're going to do here is we're going to take part 110. So we'll do this individually. So 110, 111, 112, 113, 120, 121, and then 122. Okay, so this is at 600, 1,000, 500, 200, 400, 1,600, and then 300. So when we're looking at in terms of what's the inventory value, we have to record at the lower of cost or net realizable value. So cost was 95, 60, 80, 170, 205, 16, and 240. NRV was, or basically our market was 100. 52, 76, 180, 208, 1, and then 235. So when we're showing at reporting value, lower of B or C, and we'll call this simply D. So here it's going to be 95. Here it's going to be the net realizable value. Here is going to be 76. Here is going to be 170. Here it's going to be 120. Here it's going to be a dollar. And then lastly, we're going to have this over here at 235. Now, in terms of going through and why do we do this? And the example I always like to share with my students is that what if we had 1,000 iPhone 3s that we purchased for $1,000 a unit? And if I'm showing these on my financial statements and it's 2020, these units are now fully, they're completely outdated. And, you know, I don't have any, as far as I have to go through and I have to report that inventory at the lower of cost or market. And the reason why is that if I left it at cost, it would be deceptive to investors. So to do this first part over here, I'm going to take the quantity times D, or 600 times 95. So my total inventory value using the lower of cost or market on an individual item basis is 335,100. There's also, I can do lower of cost or market in the aggregate. I can do it with inventory items individually, or I can do it with groups of inventory. So this next one here is asking us to apply it to the total of the inventory. So for this one here, what I would do is this one, we're gonna be looking over here at, if I'm doing it to the total value of the inventory. So that means that I'm just going to kind of disregard the items individually and look at everything in the aggregate. What I'm now going to do is I'm going to say, okay, if I'm applying everything in the aggregate, my total cost of all my goods was $370,600. Over here, my market, the total aggregate value here was 341,300. So if I'm reporting here the value of the inventory in the aggregate method to the total inventory, then I would be showing it at the lower of cost or market, which would be 341,300. So that would be part B. But part A right over here, this would be to each item, the value of this is 335,100. Okay. So I want to thank you for joining me here today, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a great one.